Good morning and welcome back to the channel. It is me, it is Jim, it is Tuesday. We are carrying on with more of the album The Architect from eMolecule. This is the project that is Simon Collins and Kelly Nordstrom. People ask me, do I know about this, which is Sound of Contact and the album Dimensional. It's the same people. This has got a few more people involved in it, but that's Simon Collins and Kelly Nordstrom as well. So, no, I haven't heard that. I've got it, but that's on the list to come. So that should be interesting for some people. Now, we've listened to two sides so far, and we now move to side three. We've got three tracks on here: The Turn, Awaken, Beyond Belief, and then we'll finish off with side four, which is The Universal, My You, Moment of Truth. Now, Awaken on here is very short in comparison to the Yes one. It's about 5 minutes, so it's obviously not the same thing at all. Right. I think we're good to go. Let's do it. Feels like the music for some sort of Scandinavian murder noir TV program. Very cool sound. Good.
If this is Awaken, it couldn't be far any different from the Yes version, could it? It could be more different.
Maybe that wasn't Awaken. Maybe that's still the turn. I don't know. I don't think enough time has passed for it to have been that, so this is Awaken. This is Awaken now.
Save all the world, so I'll start with myself. I will start with myself. And I know I can't stop all the pain, but I will learn to love again. I will learn to love again.
This is very different.
Will awaken.
feels very strange song to have amongst everything else on here. Excuse me. It's quite poppy. I don't know whether they've used auto-tune on his vocal, but it, in my brain, I can hear auto-tune, and it might not be there, but...
Beyond belief. Allegedly featuring guitaring from someone in Meshuggah. A bit of a Depeche Mode feel to it. Right. It seems like it's a strange little side, that. It's all sort of quite sort of quirky pop songs. And apart from the first one, and maybe I got that wrong when I was saying where the Sugar guy is playing, because if he was on that track there, beyond belief, I don't know why they'd have had him on there. Additional guitars on Beyond Belief. Okay, well, he was Frederick Thorndendal. Maybe he just happened to be in the studio at the time, and so do you want to do something? Yeah, I'll do something. And that was that. So no sort of Meshuggah vibes, I'm afraid, at all. However, it's odd. I think the first side and the second as well. There was so much incredible just stuff happening that by the time I got to this side, I think maybe they've used everything up. I don't know. It just feels a little bit of a letdown after the first two sides. I mean, they're still good songs, sort of catchy pop songs, and it's kind of just doesn't quite sit right with everything else that's sort of come along so far. But we'll see where we go with side four. Is it enough to sort of bring the album down? I don't know. I very much like the first bit, and we'll see how we end up finishing the album. Right, I'll see you on the next video, whenever and whatever that is. Until then, this is over.